Hello everyone, welcome back to today's class. In previous class, we discussed equation of a line passing through the given two points and we discussed based upon that theorem, problems also we discussed. And today's class will continue with the another concept, angle between the two lines. Line forms we discussed. Angle between two lines we have to find. We have the two types here, vector form and Cartesian form. If vector form given, how to find the angle between two lines? And Cartesian form is the given, how to find the angle between the two lines? So two formulas are there. Just we see the formulas and next we will continue with the problems. See here. The vector form of a two lines are, vector form of a line is what passing through one point and parallel to the given vector form is r bar equal to a bar plus lambda b bar. Here two lines is there, so that's why r bar equal to a1 bar plus lambda b1 bar and r bar equal to a2 bar plus lambda b2 bar I took it. So the angle between the two lines is cos theta. Here theta is an acute angle. Cos theta is equal to magnitude of b1 bar dot b2 bar. Here b1 bar b2 bar means what here? Parallel vectors. The line equation parallel to the b1 bar and b2 bar, otherwise in the direction of b1 and b2. Dot product divided by magnitude of b1 bar into magnitude of b2 bar. Then again we have to find the magnitude. So cos theta value will be, this is which form? Vector form is taken. Next, the Cartesian form of a two lines. Cartesian form of a line passing through the point and parallel to the vector is x minus x1 by a equal to y minus y1 by b equal to z minus z1 by c. Here two lines taken, so two different points and two different direction ratio. X minus x1 by a1, y minus y1 by b1, z minus z1 by c1. Another point, another line is x2, just changing purpose only we are taking these two. And where a1, a2, b1, b2 are c1, c2, these all are direction ratios of line 1 and line 2. Then the angle between the two lines is cos theta a1, a2. Just here depending upon direction ratios. Here also direction ratio, direction vectors only we took. Here also same to same direction ratio. A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus B1 C2 by square root of A1 square plus B1 square plus B1 square into A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. This is the, when we have to use this formula? Just in Cartesian line equations. These formula when vector form of the lines taken. So based upon this one, one more point is there. Note number one, perpendicular lines are perpendicular. Perpendicular means what? Theta is equal to 90 degrees. Theta is equal to 90 degrees. Cos 90 is 0. So if you set this total value left side, it will become 0. That implies in their substitution just a1 a2 plus a1 b2 plus e1 c2 equal to 0. Perpendicular means direction ratios product, sum of the product of direction ratios equal to 0 degree. Then the two lines are perpendicular. Next, the parallel. Parallel. That time theta equal to 0. Parallel lines theta equal to 0 degrees. So that time no need to use this one. Sin theta. Sin theta is equal to square root of 1 minus cos square theta. Simplification. Then we have to substitute this one. Cos sin 0 is 0. So same direct I am writing here. If I know this condition is a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. If this condition satisfied, this is a parallel condition. Next, this one is perpendicular. If I know this condition, in problem they will ask that these two lines are perpendicular or something. This condition we have to verify. Parallel condition is asking, this condition we have to verify. A1, A2, B1, B2, A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 are the direction ratios of the line. So based upon this concept, angle between the two lines and the perpendicularity and parallel checking, total we will discuss the problems now. Next, based upon that angle between the two lines, we have to solve the problems here. Example 9. Find the angle between the pair of lines given by R bar and R bar. So this is the vector form of the line equations they given. So now you have to use the cos theta formula and simplification test. Here vector form and problem number 10 you can see there is a Cartesian form. So that time Cartesian form of cos theta formula we have to take. So solution here. Compare it with the R bar equal to A1 bar plus lambda B1 bar. R bar equal to A2 bar plus mu into B2 bar. Here, direction writing B1 bar is equal to I cap plus 2J cap plus 2K cap and B2 bar is equal to 3I cap plus 2J cap plus 6K cap. So now, cos theta, we have the formula, cos theta is equal to mod of B1 bar to B2 by magnitude of B1 bar into magnitude of B2 bar, which is the mod. Now, I will find first of all, otherwise I will write substitution just direct here. I cap plus 2j cap plus 2k cap. That part will be 3i cap plus 2j cap plus 6k cap. Divided by magnitude of B1 bar. Magnitude of B1 bar, how much here? Square root of 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square into square root of 3 square plus 2 square plus 6 square. So now mod of 1 into 3 is 3, 2 into 2 is 4, 2 into 6 is 12. So this is the dot product. In vector algebra we discussed how to do the dot product also. Divided by square root of 1 plus 4 is 9. Square root of 9 plus 4, 13, 13 plus 6, 36, 13 plus 36 is root 49. So how much you get? 16 plus 3 is 19 divided by, this is 3 into 7. Cos theta is equal. Theta is equal to how much you get? Cos inverse of mod is nothing but positive leading purpose. 19 by 21 is the angle between the given pair of lines. So this is the way of finding when line equations in vector form. Next step, problem number 10 we will see Cartesian form. Solution. Here, direction ratios of first line are A1 comma B1 comma C1 is equal to how much are the denominators? A1, B1, C1. So 3, 5, 4. Next step, direction ratios of second line are A2, B2, C2. So compare with x minus x1 by a2, y minus y2 by b2, z minus z2 by c2. So how much is there here? 1 comma 1 comma. So we know the formula. When Cartesian equation is given, cos theta is equal to mod of a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 plus, so divided by square root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square. So this is the angle between the two lines when the two lines be Cartesian form. So A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2, all we know just here substitute. Cos theta is equal to mod of A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 divided by square root of A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square to square root of 1 square plus 1 square plus 2 square. So how much you get this one? 3, 5 plus 8 divided by square root of 9 plus 25, 16. 16 plus 9 is 25 plus 25, root 50 into root 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 4 is root 6. So, mod of this one, how much you get? 8 plus 8 is 16 divided by this one we can write as a 25 into 2. 25 into 2 is nothing but 5 root 2 we can write, and this one writing as a root 3 into root 2, root 6 you will get. So simplify then, 16 divided by 5 root 2 into root 2, root 2 root 2 value is 2 into root 3, 2 1 are 2, 8 are. So how much is that? 8 by 5 root 3 is that. This simplification purpose just multiply root 3 divided to rationalization making here. So how much is that? 8 root 3 by root 3 into root 3 is 3. 3 into 5 is 15. Cos theta is equal. Implies theta is equal to how much again? Cos inverse of 8 root 3 by 15 is the angle between the two lines when the given lines in the form of Cartesian. Cartesian form is the, this is the way of finding the angle between the two lines. Next step, exercise problem number 10 and 11. Exercise 11.2, two problems is there based upon the same previous concept, angle between the two lines. So here example problem already we discussed, one is a vector form, one is a Cartesian form. Here problem number 10 based upon vector form and problem number 12 is based upon Cartesian form. So I'll explain the two problems is there. One problem I'll explain here. See here. Solution, cos theta is equal to, direct I'm writing, you can have to write here B1 bar, B2 bar, the product. Cos theta is equal to mod of, this is the B1, this is the B2. So 3 I cap plus 2 j cap plus 6 k cap dot product with I cap plus 2 j cap plus 2 k cap divided by square root of 3 square plus 2 square plus 6 square. Magnitude of B1 bar, magnitude of B1 bar, magnitude of B2 bar, this is the B2, 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square, mod. So mod of 3 into 1 is 3, 2 to the 4, 6 to the 12, divided by this value how much is it? 9 plus 4 plus 36, 36 plus 4 is 40, 49, root 49 is 7 into 4 plus 4 plus 1, 90, that is 3. So how much is it? 19 by 21, cos theta is equal. Theta is equal to how much is it? Cos inverse of 19 by 21. So this is the first problem. So next step, second problem, take as a homework. Next we'll see the exercise problem number 11. Angle between the following pair of lines which are in Cartesian form. So solution here, Cartesian form is the cos theta formula, mod of A1 K2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 divided by square root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square. So direction ratio. What are the direction ratios of line here? 2, 5, minus 1. a1, b1, c1. a2 into c2. So substitute here. a1, 2, b1, minus a1, a2, minus 1. b1, 5, b2, 8. e1, minus 3, c2, 4. Divided by square root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into square root of a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square. So now simplify this one. Minus 2 plus 40 plus minus 12 divided by square root of 4 plus 25 plus 9 square root of 1 plus 64 plus 16. 40 minus 2 is 38, 38 minus 12, 38 minus 12 is 26, divided by this value, 34 plus 4, root 38, into this value is 80 plus 1, 16 plus 64 is 80, 80 plus 1 is 81, root 81 is 9. So cos theta value this one implies theta is equal to cos inverse of 26 divided by 9 root 38. 9 root 35 is the angle between the given two lines in Cartesian form. So problem number 2, take as a homework, can do that problem with same method. Now, based upon node point, we discuss some problems here. What are the node points here? Perpendicular condition is, if direction ratios, if you know, a1, a2 plus b1, b2 plus c1, c2 is equal to 0. And parallel condition is a1 by a2, b1 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. So based upon that one, node point, the basic problems here. Find the value of P. These two lines are right angle. Right angle means 90 degrees. That means it will satisfy the condition A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 equals 0. What is A1 B1 C1 and A2 B2 C2 we have to find. We can convert this. These are the not proper forms. X minus X1 we have to get Y minus Y1 by B1 Z minus Z1. But here Y minus X is there. Convert the here, line equation. So, how to convert? You can write given lines as, so I am taking negative common, x minus x1 by 3, here 7 common, y minus 2 by 2p, z minus 3 by 2. This is the first line. So I can write this one only. X minus 1 by minus 3. Y minus 2 by 2. B by 7. Z minus 3 by 2. So now it is in standard form. X minus X1 by A1. Y minus Y1 by B1. Z minus Z1 by C1. And here. Minus 7 comma. X minus 1 by 3b equal to y minus 5 by 1 minus common z minus 6 by 5. So this one how we can write it? X minus 1 by 3b by minus 7 equal to y minus 5 by 1 equal to minus that is z minus 6 by minus 5. Therefore, the details of line 1 a1b1c1 = -3 2p/7 and 2. Next, the arcs of line a2b1b2c2 -3p/7 1 - 5. Given two lines right angle, that is perpendicular, implies a1a2 + b1b2 + c1c2 = 0. So now substitute here -3 into -3p/7 + 2p/7 into 1 + 2p2 - 5 = 0. We are taking LCM is 7 = 0. Next, problem number 13. Straight lines, two lines perpendicular to each other, we have to show. Perpendicular to each other, this condition we have to show them. So here the arcs of first line a1, b1, c1 = 7, -5, 1. The arcs of second line a2, b2, c2 = 1, 2, 3. Perpendicular condition purpose. Now a1, a2 + b1, b2 + c1, c2 = 0. We have to show that. So just the value we have to find here. 7 into 1 + -5 into 2 + 1 into 3. 7 - 10 + 3 = 0. Therefore, perpendicular. Two lines are perpendicular to each other. This condition satisfied means there is a perpendicular lines. Based upon same concept, exercise 11.2, three problems with the starting problems, we didn't discuss the problems. So based upon same concept this one. So problem number 1, so just like we were teaching for first problem, you can continue this problem. Show that the three lines with the direction cosines, these are the direction cosines, are mutually perpendicular. When direction ratios, if you know, we have the perpendicular condition. a1, a2 + b1, b2 + c1, c2 = 0. Similar way here, for direction cosines also same. l1, l2 + m1, m2 + n1, n2. If you are getting answer 0, then the two lines are perpendicular. Mutually perpendicular means 1, 2 perpendicular you have to show. 2, 3 you have to show perpendicular. Like 3, 1 we have to show the perpendicular. So total 3 cases. First one are going for line 1 and line 2. This one line 1. First line BC L1 M1 N1 = 12/13 - 3/13 - 4/13. Second line BC L2 M2 N. So what are the 4/13, 1/13, 3/13. So now we have to check L1, L2 + M1, M2 + N1, N2. So how much you get here? 12/13 × 4/13 + -3/13 × 12/13 - 4/13 × 3/13. So total is 169 LCM. 13 × 13 = 169. 48 - 12 = 36 - 12. Total will be 0/169, that is 0. Therefore, 1 is perpendicular to second line. This one is a case 1. Next, case 2 we have to check about second line and third line. case 3, we have to check that third line and first line. So same similar M1, that and this one, L2, M2, N2. Is this value. Substitute and simplify. 0, 0, you get final conclusion by above three conditions. Three lines are mutually perpendicular. This one take as a homework. Next step. Problem number 2. Show that the lines to the points again. Points is perpendicular to the line passing through the points segment. Two points of a line segment. So we can find the direction ratios here. Solution. Just direction ratios of first line. First line. A1, B1, C1 is equal to. Just subtraction. B-1, 4 minus half minus 1, minus 2 minus 1. 2, 5, minus 4. Next, B cars are second line. You know the point, direction ratios formula is there. X2 minus X1, Y2 minus Y1, Z2 minus Z1. A2, B2, C2. 3 minus 0, 5 minus 3, 6 minus 2. 3, 2, 4. Now, you have to check that A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2. Just substitute the values here. 2 into 3 plus 5 into 2 plus minus 4 into plus 3 to the 6 plus 6, 10 minus 16. So total will be 0. Therefore, the two lines are perpendicular. We can write the lines are perpendicular. So this is the way of finding the perpendicularity by using the direction ratios concept. Direction cosine also same. L1 L2 plus M1 N2 plus M1 N2 is equal to 0. One more problem. Third problem in exercise. Based upon this concept. And this is the last problem based upon this concept. And previous problems we discussed only examples and exercise problems. Total we discussed about the perpendicularity condition. And only one problem they given as a parallel condition. So we discussed in 1.2 conditions, perpendicularity and parallel condition. So here based upon parallel condition, we have to solve this problem. So line to the points. Two lines parallel we have to show. Parallel means what? A direction ratios, if you know, A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2. The condition satisfied or not, we have to check. Solution. Direction ratios of first line A1, B1, C1 is equal to 2 minus 4, 3 minus 7, 4 minus 8, minus 2, minus 4, minus 4. Direction ratios of second line A2, B2, C2. 1 minus half minus 1, 2 minus half minus 2, 5 minus 1, 2, 4, 4. So now I'll find A1 by A. How much will it? Minus 2 by 2 is minus 1. B1 by B, minus 4 by 4 is 1, minus 1. C1 by C, minus 4 by 4. Therefore, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. Therefore, given lines are parallel. Why? Because this A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2 condition satisfied means theta is equal to 0. So, by this problem, based upon this angle between the lines and node points, problems completed. And today class also complete by this problem. Next class will continue the remaining concept.